Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to talk to you about my 4-year ownership of this Arai XT4 helmet. I've owned this helmet for 4 years now and I bought it brand new. I think the price range hasn't really changed since then. It's still gonna run you about $550 to $600. Depends on where you buy it from and especially additional with upgrades. So what it comes with off the factory is just itself with plain visor. It doesn't come with pin lock. And of course, this helmet setup, I have my PacTalk Slim on here. And I did weigh it. So the weight of this helmet with the PacTalk Slim is 3 pounds and 10 ounces. And this is a size small. It is DOT and Snell approved. That's why I chose this helmet. This is actually my first motorcycle helmet when I started riding. And it was recommended to me by my brother because he said that amongst all the helmets he's tried, like 20 plus helmets, and this is the go-to helmet. And when I started riding and I geared more towards dual sport bikes and adventure riding and more that kind of stuff, this is actually the helmet that's the best overall for that. Even moto touring, even if you never left the pavement, long distance touring, I find that this helmet, I keep going back to it. I personally have 3 helmets. So I use the other ones and I'm like, oh, you know, I should try something else. But I keep going back to this helmet every single time. I even have a carbon fiber helmet, but I still go back to this helmet every single time. I like that it has the beak because commuting a lot in different types of weather and the sun, and when you're riding straight in the horizon and the sun is right in your face, you can just tilt down a little bit and block the sun that way. In the beginning, it was a little annoying because I do live in San Francisco and the wind creates a lot of buffeting, and it does when you, there are times in San Francisco when you're on the freeway and you're on the highest point of the freeway where there's really no buildings next to you, and the wind can get really gnarly, like the Bay Bridge and some freeways. And if you are, depending which bike you're taking, that also depends, because if you have a bike with a tall windshield like my GS, then it doesn't matter. But if you're on a bike like the 701, which has no windshield, it's a little bit of an issue when you're going fast, you're turning to your side to check before you switch lanes, and you can get the wind, how do you call it, like a wind slap when you're turning. So I had worked my way around that, commuting a lot. So what I do is, to fix that problem, is I just tilt my head down a little bit every time I have to turn, and then I turn that way instead of turning when I'm upright and turning this way, and then the wind force is much stronger. So going back into the helmet, I really like it a lot because it is, for me, a four-season all-around helmet. I've ridden this in extreme heat and cold, not snow, just wanna, no snow in San Francisco, so no snow, but it has a lot of vents. So as you can see here, the stock shield, I'm just gonna go ahead and disconnect my earplugs because it's just in the way. So the stock shield has brow vents on both sides, brow vents. And the chin vent, there's actually an outer vent on the chin and an inner vent inside. So they have what I would say a double venting feature here. And there's also side vents. So you see that this thing that looks like a speaker is actually also a vent. So you can open and close that. And the controls are on the inside right here. Hopefully you guys can see that. And in terms of the top of the head venting, So the, as you can see, the visor here has slits where the air can flow through. And there's these top vents right here. So you just need to open it up. And the side here, that also vents. So when it's raining, obviously you can close all of these vents and then you'll be good to go. But the problem I had in the beginning was, okay, first of all, San Francisco is always crazy foggy. It's misty, even though it's summer. It will be windy, misty, muggy, similar to Seattle in some ways. And it didn't come with pinlock visors for a $500-something helmet, you know, which sucks, because some cheaper helmets do come with pinlock ready visor. So you can just buy the insert. This one doesn't come with anything. You have to buy it separately. So I can't remember the price off the top of my head how much those upgrade visors are, but I'd say more or less $60 and then pinlock for $20, something like that. So I did buy two extra visors. I have the clear with the pinlock, and I also have the shaded visor for just extremely sunny days. And when I did the pinlock upgrade, so I changed it to pinlock with the insert, I could actually ride in rain and heavy fog and mist without the visor fogging up, even with this all the way closed. Because the reason I say that is because some people would say, oh, you can, you know, you just open it a little bit as long as there's a little crack. But the rain sometimes is really bad. You know, if it's like heavy rain and you just have to go, even if it's a little crack like this, your face will get wet. Well, mine did. That was my experience. That's why I switched to pinlock. Anyways, I should show you guys that pinlock in case some people don't know what that is. I wanted to show you the opening of this visor, and as you can see, it's dirty. I didn't clean it. So all the way close, and you can crack it open a little bit. So that's the first crack, which is pretty small, which I thought was nice, because some helmets, the first crack is really like that. In which case, I mean, if you're riding fast, that's a big crack. But this one, that's why I think it's good. Then it has three, so one, and then one where like this. I never wear it like this. It's either just a little bit of crack like that, or I would click it all the way close, or I'll leave it all the way open. So another thing that I wanna touch base on is they have these, it comes off easily, the cheek pads. So it's called an emergency tab. There's an emergency tab inside in case you get into an accident and you know, the medical team needs to remove the helmet. It'll make it easier for them to just pull the cheek pads off, and then it'll be easier for them to remove the helmet that way. So the cheek pads are really easy to reinstall back in there. The inner liner, I'm gonna remove it. It's held on by these tabs. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can wash the liners, and that way they're always fresh. But as you can see, these have been used for 4 years. So it still looks pretty good to me, but it definitely doesn't look like it's brand new anymore. Okay, this is what the inside looks like. In terms of long range riding, if I am riding all day, in the beginning I did feel like this helmet was a little heavy, but I think I just got used to it. Like I said, this is 3 pounds and 10 ounces. I weighed it multiple times and I'm like, okay, is it really 3 pounds and something something? So it's 3 pounds, 10 ounces with the PackTalk Slim I didn't weigh it without the communicator because to me it didn't make sense since all of my helmets always have a communicator, so it has to be weighed with that included. So I'll just show you guys the visors that I actually bought with this helmet. So this is the shaded visor, the dark smoke shaded visor that I got, and it also comes with the brow vents. And this is the clear with the pin lock. I don't like wearing the pin lock visor when I don't need to because it does create a different point of view. I think that's how you call it. It's not as clear to me. Like you can have a... it's not really a glare. I don't know how to explain it, but it definitely feels different looking through pin lock visor with the pin lock insert than if you're looking through just a regular lens, regular visor without the pin lock. And one thing that I do not like about this helmet is only because it's really annoying to change visors. I have other helmets where the only, you know, that if you want to change visors, you just click and then it comes off. This one, you have to unscrew them. So mine came with a tool, but you can use like a quarter or basically a flathead to remove these screws. So 1, 2, 3, 4 screws. You have to deal with 4 screws if you want to change from this visor to this visor to this visor. And when I first started moto touring, I did bring the extra visors. And then recently I've been too lazy, so, and I didn't want to bring too much stuff if I don't need to, so I just stuck with the plain one. Depending on the weather, if it's right now, it's just more drought, wildfires, dry, and I just sacrifice the, I don't wear the smoke shield even though it's more comfortable. I just go with this one, and I'm not gonna deal with fog. And where I was going anyway, I didn't have to deal with fog, mist, rain. There was no such forecast of those, so I just used the original visor that this came with. And if it was easier to change, then I probably would think about, okay, I could bring all the other visors with me. But I had to pull over at the side of the road because I have to switch visors because I was wearing this and then it started getting dark and it's not happening, or I had to change to this visor because I can't, you know, if it was starting to rain. Actually, that kind of happened, but I think it was because I'm up in the mountains, or I was like, what the hell, it didn't say forecast rain. But luckily it didn't last very long. It was just like a short rain and then it stopped. One thing why I didn't wanna, so you guys might be thinking, well, just use this visor all the time. So I did, I used to. But the problem with this is I did end up riding at night a few times, and riding with this at night gave me some weird glare. It's kind of playing tricks on my vision. So it was so hard to ride with this. And if I open the visor, and you could say, oh, just ride with it open, but then there's bugs and stuff that will go on my face, and it was really dark already. So I believe me, I tried everything and it was just not, I didn't think it was safe. So there's a chance of me riding at night, I'm better off with the plain visor at that point. I think that one occasion where it was the worst was because it was just pitch black. I would not recommend riding with this at night if your bike doesn't have enough lights, first of all, and your surrounding is pitch black. It was playing tricks on my vision. So I think that's all. Hopefully I covered everything. It's a little more expensive than the average helmet. I mean, you can get ADV helmets for less than $300, but this, if you've been shopping for one or trying to look for one, you'll notice that a lot of adventure riders wear this helmet they also wear the other ones like the climb and Nex helmet, but there's more that wear this. They've been around for so long, they've, you know, well tested, and they're really all around really good helmet. I am coming up to 5 years, and they said that you're supposed to replace your helmet every 5 years. So I don't know if I'm going to want to try a different helmet or just buy another one of these. But me personally, I really love this helmet. And now I'm starting to wonder why I bought so many other helmets since I only just wear this one. Well, that's all for this video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you do, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and put it in the comments if you guys have other video suggestions for next time. I do take that into account, and that also helps me come up with more videos for the future. So I'll see you then.